Today, I wanted to jump back into the delivery app of Roadie. I haven't worked for them since, wow, maybe 2020. Roadie is a very versatile app where you can be delivering a pallet of items from a hardware store all the way down to a bag of prescription medication.
Have a good one. Yeah. Good to see you.
Hi, how are you?
Name and date of birth. Here's medication for your weird infection. Thank you, bye.
The only thing about it is you have to submit a bid or an offer before you're even considered to start the delivery. And this is where today's story begins.
What's up, guys? You actually caught me in the middle of a delivery. I'm gonna go pick up this point pickup order. It's like $7 for 2 miles. I'll have it here on the screen so you guys can see it. Originally, what I was trying to do is do this Roadie order here because I haven't done Roadie in a while. And I thought, let me jump in there and see if there was anything I was missing. But with Roadie, before you get the order, you have to submit an offer. And I think it's the pickup location who decides whether to accept you or not. And I couldn't submit my offer right away because I was not certified to do prescription delivery, so I had to do a little certification real quick. It was very fast, just a few little videos you watch, and then they had a pop quiz at the end. But I think since I just got certified, they rejected me because they wanted somebody with a little bit more experience to drop off the order, which is fine. But the crazy part is, after they rejected me, the order is still here in the queue. But luckily, I saw this point pickup order. It was like right down the street from me, and that's where I'm headed to right now. So I got the order. By the app, it says I'm a little early. I'm supposed to pick it up at 1:30. And right now, you guys probably can't see that, but it's 1:20. And as I say right here, arriving to the pickup time prior to this is not allowed. Which is really strange that they would say that, because I would think you would much rather have it early than late. What do I know? I'm just a dude out here delivering groceries. And for those of you who are wondering, yeah, that order for Roadie is still there. All you had to do was let me deliver it. That person could have got their drugs. So I just pulled over here real quick because Point Pickup, as I was dropping that last order off, text messaged me, which is a little odd, but they were asking me if I could help them out. It looks like they have an order at a place called At Home. It's like a furniture store. The order is $65 though, so I was intrigued. I was like, man, that would really help out my day. But there's always a catch. So the location of At Home is a place I was actually planning on driving anyway. I've been having some pretty good success out there in those orders. Plus, it's kind of chill and I don't have to deal with a lot of craziness. So that's not the problem, but it's the drop-off location. They want me to drive to a whole other part of Texas. It'll be an hour drop-off with this many miles. I don't know. You guys let me know. It's not something that I'm going to do, but let me know if it's something that you guys would do. So, yeah, I'm just gonna have to leave them on red, unfortunately. Just out of curiosity, I wonder if anyone ever picked up that Roadie order. Looks like they did. This is another, this is a different $3 one. 3 miles for seven. 12 for 12 and 14 miles for $10. All right, guys, I just got a notification that this Roadie was available. It's $8 for 5 miles. I'm not sure what this company is, but I'm gonna do a submission and see if I can actually get this one. I don't see much as far as the package details go, but it is due immediately. So let's go ahead and submit offer and let's see what happens. Oh, never mind. I'm just not having the best luck with Roadie. I knew there was a reason I stayed out of this app. All right, change locations because I wasn't getting much over there. These are the two Instacart orders that are currently on my screen. 9 items for $24, that's great. But not for 34 miles. Ay, chihuahua. All right, finally got something. I think I'm going to go ahead and take this one because I've been sitting here for quite a while. I hate taking orders out of scarcity, thinking that nothing else better is going to come through, or in my case, nothing at all. And I was sitting there for quite a while, and that was the best thing that showed up. But sometimes you just got to do what you got to do. And I need to put a little bit more money on my books today because the funds are looking a little dry. But it really is a balancing act because while you're stuck doing this order, or let me say working, not stuck. While you're working this order, you could be missing out on those 20, 40, or unicorn $100 orders. You know, but no one knows what the algorithm holds. Let's do what we can to make quick work of this one.
Repeat that time, folks.
So I don't know how true this is, but I heard if you keep accepting low offers on Instacart, they're going to keep sending you low offers. Maybe I'm pigeonholing myself into this $10 to $20 range, but I have seen some $30 ones. Haven't seen any $40, haven't seen any like $80 or $100 in a long time. Could be my account or could just be my market.
The one good thing about this order, everything is over here in the cleaning section, so not bad.
All right, we got 16 minutes on the 20. The first location looks like we're gonna be heading to a home, which is awesome. The second location that has the firewood, how much you wanna bet it's gonna be an apartment? We'll find out. All right, peeps, we're off to the next location. I'll let you decide if this is gonna be a house or if it's gonna be an apartment. If you get it right, go in your pantry and get yourself a cookie. If you don't have any cookies, I don't know. Get yourself a glass of water. We can all use more water. All right, guys, we're here. What do you think it is? It's a house. Go get those cookies, or better yet, go get that water. Speaking of water, this video is sponsored by, I'm kidding. I am kidding. Wish I wasn't though. Azorca, give me a call. All right, I had just dipped into this parking lot because there were some orders coming in on Instacart that I just wanted to double check before I snatched the batch. I didn't get a chance to screenshot it, but it was a Target order. It was like $24 for 18 items, and it was for two customers, and I think it was like 6 miles to drop it off. Just as I was doing that, so let me go back into the queue and just double check. And then this Randall's order came in. It's 5 items, $16, 6 miles. I was like, you know what? I'll go ahead and do that, and it's for one customer. Plus, that was the parking lot I pulled into, which is probably why they gave it to me. All right, looks like we're making ready for a special occasion. They got a cookie platter, cupcakes, some more cupcakes, and two bouquets of flowers. Let's hope they have everything in stock. All right, just confirmed with the bakery about these cupcakes, because it looks like they all come with these like cartoon toppers. So I'm not sure what kind of party this is, but if this is for like older people, I don't think they want to look at Barbie, Luigi, and SpongeBob, but that's all they have out, so we'll see what they say. I mean, they could just pull them off. All right, looks like it is fine. Cool. Let's keep the party moving. Man, they got some nice old cars here. She said leave them by the garage door. To me, that seems like a very strange place to leave cupcakes, but who am I to question it? I don't know how much money people have spent on their Christmas decorations this year, but they are really trying to get their money worth because those bitches are still out. Put Frosty and Rudolph in the garage. It's over. Wow. It seemed like it took forever to get to this store. And guys, it's only been about 10 minutes from the last clip you saw. I don't know. I just zoned out. I was driving over here like I was going through the Twilight Zone. Insane. And now it looks like order for what you call it has been removed from your list. Now it looks like I'm shopping for just one person. I wonder what that's going to do for my earnings. Let's see which one we actually get to keep. Looks like it's going to be customer B. They wanted 6 items. So now we're down to just the 15 items. So man, it gets dark quick. All right, that's more like it. We only had one refund to do, but we got out of here in 16 minutes. All right, guys, it is about 7 o'clock. Just dropped that order off, and this is what it'll be looking like right now on Instacart. This one's pretty good, but it's, oh, somebody got it. It looked like it was 3 customers at Target. This one's not bad. Let's do this one, 12 for 17. Yeah, let's do that one. That's another one where I was very tempted to get this first one. I screenshot, I was gonna go do that one. I was like, you know what? Let me go right back into the queue and just refresh it and see what happens. Then that $17 one popped up. So that's the one I'm gonna go with. To me, that seems like a better option, which has me thinking, if I waited longer, would I got a $100 order? Probably not. Probably not. Pretty awesome, they got all of their substitutions already inside the app. And if I need something, I can text them, but pretty much have to go on this one. Spoke too soon. I've never done so many substitutions in my life. This place is under remodel, so that's why, but man. Said before, the easy ones are never easy. Let that be a lesson. Don't shop at a store during a remodel. Let me give them enough space, because this door swings outward. Sometimes it's not the physical work. It can be the mental gymnastics that can really beat you down. But that's the nature of the beast. Got this Dollar Tree order in here for $13. I feel like if I was to do that, which I'm never going to shop at Dollar Tree, because when has Dollar Tree ever had anything in stock? I feel like I'll be subbing out this whole order just like I did the last one. So yeah, we'll pass on that. So let me not do Dollar Tree like that. It's not that they don't have it in stock. It's probably all just in boxes in the back. So I guess if I wanted to dig through their inventory, I probably could find some of that stuff. But no ma'am, sir. So I'm sitting right here waiting for some more orders to come in. I got pretty much all the apps running. And I'm looking at my calculations for my earnings, and they are abysmal, guys. Like, they are not good right now. It's really making me question if I should have took that at-home furniture order from Point Pickup earlier today. But let's see what we got. We got Uber here. All right, so we got a DoorDash order here. It's a red card order. It was a red card order. I think it was $6 for 2 miles. It was 8 items you have to go into Walgreens and shop. I try to stay above $12 if I'm going to do a shop and pay order. Above 12, 15 would be the best, but yeah. So we wait, Okay, so I don't know if I was just in a dead zone or what, but nothing was coming in where I was parked. So I went about 4 blocks down the street, heading to this little area that I found, and it's been saving me most nights. So hopefully tonight it will do the same. I got this order right here. It's an Instacart order. I'm going to go run in here and shop this really, really quick. And hopefully I can make enough money tonight so I can afford a can of soup. Because it got bad all of a sudden. Well, guys. Despite my best efforts, I'm gonna have to pull the plug on the video. I've been sitting here literally for about an hour and 30 minutes and nothing has come in. I have Instacart open right now, as you guys can see. There's an order for Target. It's 4 items, 1 mile, $6. What am I gonna do with that? Uber is open. Uber's open. Nothing. I can't Dash now. Where is DoorDash? Here it is. I can only schedule myself. Believe it or not, Grubhub has been on this entire day and has sent me nothing, nothing at all. So it is 10 o'clock, actually 10 o'clock on the dot. You guys can see here. Oops, what's this? But that was an hour ago. 10 o'clock on the dot. So I'm just gonna pull it. Seems like my most recent videos have always started to end like this. I was hoping and hoping and hoping for something to turn around and I came to my spot and it just did not happen. Understand, guys, sometimes it's like this. And these days, as many people have mentioned in my comments, it's getting harder and harder to make $200. For those who can actually still pull it off, $200 and above, I commend you. I actually think I had Walmart Spark on early today and they sent me nothing. So I don't know if it's just something going on with my devices, if I was just in a bunch of dead zones. I don't know what it was. I was really trying. You guys saw me hustling, but I'm gonna go home, regroup, and come out tomorrow and hope to have a better day. You probably wondering, okay, what did you make, dude? I'm gonna put some numbers here on the screen. And I want you guys to guess how much I made today. Comment it below. And when I see it, I'll let you know in the comment section. I'll tell you one thing, it's not great. It is not great. No sense of wasting more time being out here. I can actually go home, get some rest, get an early start tomorrow, be re-energized. And that way I can hit the ground running that much harder tomorrow. If you do, comment below, let me know what your market's looking like these days. I have so many people saying they went back to a W-2 because there's just no money in doing this. And for me, I'm starting to see it. Do your best to keep your head up. I'm gonna try, even though I wanna cry. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Sorry, extended credits. I just refused to go out like that. So I'm gonna try to do some user testing. And luckily, there's a few tests I might be able to qualify for. Let's give it a shot.
What's going on? I'm done. Cut the show. I'm done.
I tried.
Take me off.